Hello and welcome to Welsh Board GCSE ICT. This podcast continues to look at home and personal communication systems, specifically internet connections. This is for the home and personal communication section of the Unit 1 exam. So, we're continuing. We've looked at different ways we can connect to the internet. We've looked at what internet connections are available, and you've been able to select the most appropriate method of internet connection. That's what we've been doing so far. We've looked at lots of different connections. We've looked at broadband, we've looked at satellite, we've looked at dial-up, and we've looked at cable. So that only really leaves one type of connection left, which is a growing connection, which more and more people are using as kind of not a replacement to satellite and dial-up, but as quite an affordable substitute. So, finally then, mobile communications. The first one is via a dongle. You can see it in the corner there. This kind of connection here, this can plug into a laptop, and that'll give you this mobile connection to the internet. Mobile internet. But what's also worth remembering as well is this equipment is also, this technology is also built into most mobile phones, which means that you might not need special equipment, you can just use your phone to do this instead. So the first one is 3G. And obviously, as it says there, 4G is currently in development. So 3G is where you access the internet using data, mobile data technology. So phone masts are around the country that allow you to view data on your mobile phone, the internet on your mobile phone. You can use them to go on the internet. Now that can be accessed via mobile phones, as I've already said, and also by a computer using a dongle that plugs in for a subscription instead of a phone. So it's reasonably fast, not bad for internet on the move, not really suitable for high quality videos. You can stream some videos, but not very high quality, and it is specific to where you are in the country. Then you've got HSDPA, which is a little bit older, but not older than 3G, but quite old for its time now. It's very high speed data access with your phone. It gives you 7 meg internet access with newer versions reaching 20 plus. So imagine 7 megabytes of internet access through your phone. That gives you like a broadband equivalent style internet connection on your mobile phone. So you can do anything you would on a PC on your phone. Quite fast indeed. And the same on your laptop as well with a HSDPA connection through that. However, you need to be in a 3G or HSDPA area. And not every area in the UK supports HSDPA or 3G. Sometimes you might be in an area that doesn't support either, which means that you'd be better off with a dial-up connection in some cases. You do need special equipment if you want to use it via your laptop, a dongle. And that'll often result in a monthly fee, like a £10 a month to do that. But the good thing is it's portable, so you can plug that dongle in the middle of a countryside, and assuming you've got 3G there, you can access the internet. You can stick it in on the train, you can stick it in when you're at school, at work, or in the journey somewhere. You can get internet access wherever you are without paying extra charges because you've got that connection. So you can download and stream relatively well. It's not brilliant, but it's alright. It does. Most people, the average kind of user who moves around a little bit or doesn't want to commit themselves to an internet connection inside their home when they might use it in more than one place. So, that's it. If we take a look at what we've done so far, we've got broadband. Remember, average kind of family, lots of people use it, lots of different providers out there, which means it's relatively cheap. It's relatively fast it's really fast, from 2 megs right up to 100 megabytes connection for really intense use in the home or business. Satellite for people who can't get broadband, around about £30 a month, relatively okay but a bit jittery, does a bit stuttery online when you're using it, so it's not really good for gaming. You've got mobile communications like 3G or HSDPA through your phone or through something called a dongle which plugs into your machine for a monthly subscription of around about £10. Reasonably fast, can give you up to broadband speeds, and you can take it anywhere with you. Same as you can for satellite. Dial up to fixed connection through your phone line, extremely slow, painfully slow, often charges per minute, but is really good for the kind of person who doesn't want to use the internet very regularly. So if they're going to send the odd email every month, that'd be fine. And cable provides the same benefits of broadband. So that's what we've done. We look at the different ways you can connect. They're the different ways, the different connections available, and you should now, when presented with scenarios in lesson or as revision, be able to select the most appropriate connection. Hope you've enjoyed today's session. Thank you very much. My name is Chris Coleman.